Acknowledge love, learn and know love.
I'm so excited about this word. Like, God has changed my life. Like, I could, oh my goodness, I could literally do laps around the room right now because he's changed my life with this on a question I've asked for years. And I hear the same question on TikTok, on Christian TikTok, all the time. And I haven't heard it from any of the sermons I've watched, the podcasts I've listened to, or any of the church circles I've been in for years. And it's, he's putting me in this waiting season, but why? Why am I having to wait for so long whenever I'm following you? I see other people out here doing the wrong things and they're getting these beautiful relationships. But why is it that whenever I'm following you and I'm requesting biblical love, I'm having to wait for so long? I ask questions like, God, do you just not want me to have love? Why don't you want this for me? Song of Solomon 2:2, let's go. Like a lily among the thorns, so is my darling among the maidens. And you might say, Claudia, what does this verse have to do with anything? And what this has to do with anything is that Song of Solomon is a whole book surrounding love. Two people who demonstrate very biblical love to each other. This is eros love. This isn't necessarily agape love. This book was written before Christ comes, but it is a parallel to how Christ will love the church, okay? And what this verse is saying is he's basically, it's the guy, he's talking to the girl, and he's like, you don't know you're beautiful. But no, what he's saying is, I look at all these other girls and I see a bunch of thorns and you're like the flower. Like, I love you the most. I only have eyes for you. All the hopeless romantics are going, oh, that's so cute. Yeah, there's a whole book about it. Read about it. I want that. Me too. And guess what? God wants that for you. And here's what he's saying on a very real note. It's not that I don't want you to have love, son or daughter. I want you to experience perfect love. And that's why I'm requiring you to wait. Because in my order of the way that I want things to go down, I want you to experience love in a beautiful way, the way I intended for it to experience. And so whenever you are following my righteous path, there are going to be people who I say, I'm not allowing them to be in your life because they don't know me and I am love. And if they don't know love itself, then how are they going to know how to love you? Saying some of y'all don't even know my love. You don't have a relationship with me. You don't know my biblical pure love. So how are you going to recognize it whenever it walks through that door? You won't, because you don't spend time with me. You don't have a relationship with me where you understand what that love is. And this is the part that just, he said, Claudia, my love for you is not supposed to be symbolic of how one day you'll be loved by somebody. Their love for you in that romantic relationship is supposed to be symbolic of how I love you. A romantic relationship is meant to show you how I love you. I am not meant to show you how one day you could be loved by somebody else. And we get it so backward. And we say, well, we're in this waiting room and I guess we'll have to settle for God's love. He goes, no, that was the point the whole time. Because some of y'all need a romantic relationship to understand how I love you. But if you can be content with me and if you can understand my love for you, you'll be set. You don't understand just how much I love you and my perfect love for you. And yeah, romantic relationship is great. I want that for you. That's why I have a whole book that demonstrates you how to love other people. But if you're not understanding my love, you're not going to recognize it when it goes through the door. So yeah, I'm making you wait, but it's not because I don't want you to have love. It's because I want you to have such a beautiful love that you can see me through it.
God will find you. Sunland Apple IPTV Entertainment Perfected Faces done by Candy.
See, I didn't find God in the church. In fact, I didn't find God at all. He found me. He met me in a place where I was so broken, I couldn't get up. And when you're loved like that, it will shock you.
Whoever needs to hear this, listen now. God did not bring you this far to leave you. He did not bring you this far to... The scripture says that he that started a good work, he starts a good work. He's faithful to see it through till the end. The work that the Lord has started in you is a good work. And he will surely see it through to the end. He says, he makes all things work together for good. For those that love the Lord and are called according to his purpose. His purpose. You did not find God. Contrary to the way it is explained today that, oh, I found God. You did not find God. God was not lost. You was lost. God found you. And so if he finds you, he is big enough, strong enough and able enough to secure you and to keep you. You've got to believe that. In the book of Matthew, Matthew chapter 6 verse 44, it says, "No one can come to you unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up at the last day." Christ is saying that if the Father did not send you, if the Father did not send you to him, you will not be able to know him. So God found you. So you've got to believe that if he found you and he's brought you this far, then he's faithful enough, he's able enough, and he's more than willing to see you through to the very end, because he does a good work. He doesn't do unfinished business. No, the Lord finishes his work perfectly. The book of Ephesians 2 verses 10 says that we are God's masterpiece. We are God's masterpiece. Listen to these words. Created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared for us a long time ago. So before you were even born, there was a preparation for you. You've got to believe that, because it's true. Before you were formed in your mother's womb, I knew you. I'd set you apart. Right? So there's a preparation for you. There's a plan for you. There's a purpose for you. There's a path for you. And you are a masterpiece that is going through to perfection. You will be perfected. You're going through a process that is going to take you to perfection. The Lord did not bring you this far to leave.
God wants to be pursued. He's a relational God. He's a jealous God. He wants your heart. He wants your devotion. He wants your passion. In fact, he gives us an incredible promise in Jeremiah 29, verse 13. He says this, God says, "You will seek me," and what happens when you seek me? When you seek me, he says, you'll find me. It's a promise. If you pursue God, he will reveal himself to you. You will seek me and find me. When you seek me with all your heart, God says, I will be found by you, declares the Lord. When you draw near to him, when you pursue him, when you crave him, when you hunger for him, God loves to be pursued, and he loves to reveal himself to you.
To speak to people about a peg. So when you look at a peg, Sister Lerato, there's this silver spring in the center.
Yes.
A peg cannot function without the silver spring in the center. If I remove the silver spring in the center, it'll be just two pieces of planks that mean nothing. Same thing with your life. If I remove God at the center of your heart, you'll be a meaningless person. You wouldn't know your purpose. You wouldn't know your calling. You wouldn't know who you are. Number two, when you hang clothes on a line, why do you put a peg? You put a peg so that impacts a zinga or a zinga gold. Same thing with your life. Why do you receive God in your life? You receive God so that you don't fall into depression, anger, anxiety, bitterness, jealousy. That is why you need God in your life, so that you can be who you are and know your identity and purpose. Number three, if I remove the clothes from the pegs, impahla zonzakalayo, zizohole. So that is why it's very important to stick onto the Lord. Number four, Apex does not discriminate, Sister Lerato. It doesn't matter whether you are rich, whether you are poor, whether you are filthy, whether you are dirty. Apex's job is to hold you back. It does not matter who you are. Apex is going to hold you. Isn't this the same thing that God says, come as you are? It doesn't matter how broken. It doesn't matter what happened in your life. God is saying that just come as you are. Right now, during this lockdown, there's somebody that's broken. It's saying that, I have no future. There's no hope, Bungan. But I want to tell you, God is saying, come as you are. And the word fear, Sister Lerato, the word fear, this word, fear, it has two meanings for me, Sister Lerato. It says, first meaning is from the enemy. And people will say, forget everything and run away from the promises that God has for you. It's saying forget. But I want you to turn it around today. I don't care what situation you're facing today. Turn it around. Face everything and rise. I don't care what situation you've been through. A lot of people, they might have thrown stones. Like, dogs do not bark at a car that stands still, but dogs bark at a car that's moving. So what I'm telling you, run, hustle. It's difficult. Today I'm an author, Sister Lerato. My friends, when I shut my
wish you could trade eyes with me. There's complexities in complexion, but your skin is glow like diamonds.
dig me like the earth, you be giving birth to everything alive, baby, know your worth. I love everything about you, from your nappy curls to every single curve, your body natural. Same skin that was broken, me the same skin taking over. Most things are to focus you, but when you're in the room, they notice you. Tells your story. Keep dancing, they can't control.